$100,000. And don't let this trick you, because this is a lot less than $100,000. This is actually like 20 bucks, but I have six daughters, so if I really count this, there's probably only about 15 or 14 left, and then there's this thing, which that is because we own a dog. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can make $14.5. Not so much of a catchy title name, right? We gotta do $100,000, not this $14 thing. And on average, most people were making around $20 an hour using this approach. $19.23 to be exact, because I had a calculator, and you don't even have to drive for Uber. And a little insight, it is not Amazon, it's not eBay, it's not even dropshipping. You actually don't even need to use a computer. You don't have to have a computer to make this stuff. Now I gotta clean it. Man, I hope that looks good in post-editing, because now I gotta clean all this stuff up. Some people complain to me. They're like, Bill, hurry up and get to the point. Okay, it's this stuff right here. I'm gonna show you about this stuff and how to get this stuff. This is what you're gonna be doing. See these? These are pennies. Like, there's full-blown YouTube communities about getting these things. And guess what? We're starting right now. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here and this is the first time you've ever seen me, my name is Bill. Really doesn't matter, but what I am going to do for you in this video and every video that I've ever done is help you make more money. That's it. That's why my channel exists. And actually, it exists for you to subscribe to. That's all I ask. You don't have to buy anything. I'm not selling anything. Like, right now, nothing to be sold. I just give you the truth, and hopefully this truth is going to set you free. This is what the whole video is about. Coin roll hunting. Not goodwill hunting. Coin roll hunting. People are making $100,000 a year finding these things. Like, I just was going through my change in my pockets and in my car, and I guess these things actually can be worth a whole lot of money. And actually, how much do you think this penny is worth? Well, guess again, because good condition buys you a used Lamborghini. $75,000 for that penny that you just saw. And because that's all I do all day long, besides teach high school and run businesses, is I scour the interwebs just for you to find stories about people that actually do this as a hobby. This lady, this penny right here, $24,000. And I honestly randomly just went and grabbed just a little bit of change out of my sock drawer. That's where I keep my change. So if you ever rob my house, that's where it's at, in the sock drawer. And I here's a penny, and it's 50 years old, 1970, roughly 50. Nah, it's 50, could be, right? We're right there. 50 years old penny, just sitting there. If it's double stamped, then it's worth $126,000. So these people are scouting for these things. So this video is I'm gonna teach you, like, a step-by-step, and it kind of reminds me of when I used to scout for stuff, and I used to scout for books. This was over a decade ago. And I would have this little thing here and this little thing here. And I would go, believe it or not, this is crazy, I would go to garage sales, and I'd have something in my ear, so I'd know exactly. And I'd use this little clicker here, and I'd scan a book, or I would scan a Diet Coke, and it would tell me in my ear what it would sell for on Amazon. And that is called, well, it was FBM, fulfilled by merchant, by me. And some of these garage sales that I would go to, I remember, like, just a few streets up, this guy, his whole front of his yard was stacked with these books. And I go up and I grab the first book and I scan it, and it says $675. I'm thinking, okay, my scanner must be broken. I scan another one, $425. I scan another one, $175. I scan another one. This guy had a whole front yard with these, and I don't really know too much about books. All I know is, yeah, I'll give you a busted dollar for that there book. And I bought all of his books, and I made thousands, probably tens of thousands of dollars by scanning people's stuff. And that's what people are doing with coins, because these coins are worth a lot of money, and books are worth a lot. If you want to do this, I probably have videos in the back. Maybe I'll leave a link somewhere above my head on a video that I did it on book scanning. I used to go to garage sales. I would go to book fairs. I would go to Goodwill's and just bink. It's like 10 cents, bink, 10 cents, bink, $20. I'm like, yep, I'll buy it for a buck, you know? Like, ooh, this is really, and I made more doing that than even being a high school business teacher. So I'd get out of class and I would jump in my car and I would hit some Goodwills. I'm like, sweetie, I'm going to LA. I just start hitting Goodwills or these book sales, which was crazy because it was like the whole place was covered in books and I'm hitting these things and you have a shopping bag or my wife would be behind me and I'm like throwing them in there. A friend of mine actually quit his accounting job making, I don't know, he was making like $100,000 a year. He's like, nope, I'm doing this. I am selling books. And to this day, he still does that. He now has a house paid off in Hawaii. He's doing very well, but that's a thing. But it's interesting because I went from doing this to going, hey, what if I make it myself? That's called FBA, private label products. I actually link in the description if you're interested where you, oops, I guess I need to buy a new one. You buy things like this and you put your name on it and then you sell it and you sell whatever, you know, you do your own little thing and it's pretty easy. I have like a 40-hour course on it. I think two payments of $197. Sorry, something has to pay for this darn YouTube channel, right? So if you want to learn how to do that, that's in there. But now let's do a step-by-step, let me grab these guys, on how to search for these things and what you need to do. And what I found is, because some people are gonna go, Bill, how much do I get to make? A guy named Larry, he makes $15,000 a year. Larry says that he spends 780 hours a year and makes $15,000. So that's $19.23 an hour on the side hustle. But if you don't like that, then heck, do FBA. I don't know. I'm just trying to help you out here to make an extra, you know, 15 grand a year. That's not bad, right? That probably beats working at McDonald's. And just to let you know, there are lots of people that find this interesting because as I'm going through YouTube, I'm finding channels with hundreds of thousands of subscribers. And these guys just sit there with their coin. They like film themselves, like looking at coins. And there is like live streaming of going through coins. It's a thing. Live streaming, going through this guy's coins. And it's like, woo, I got one. Yay, good job, Brian. The first thing you want to do is do like what I just did. Go through your stuff at home. Go through the coins. But then you're like, step number two, Bill, how am I supposed to know what coins are good and what coins are not? So I'm going to walk you through that also. Just about anything, especially pennies, 2009. I guess that was a year. Go with 2009 and it looks like you'll do pretty well because there was very few coinages made, very few currency made 2009. And then there is the wheat cents, the ones with the wheat on it. So that's a big hit also. And nickels, keep anything before 1960. You should do really well with that. And Buffalo nickels, works every time. And guess what year you should hold on to? The 2009 nickel. That's a keeper. And dimes, I guess dimes are a little tricky. So that's not the money maker. The money maker, from what everyone is saying, is the pennies and the nickels. And quarters, like anything before, I think it's 1965, that's all silver. And the price of silver, when that shoots up, now I don't think you're allowed to melt it. So don't do that. But silver is good. What is silver at right now? An ounce? We're looking at about, what, 15 to 20 bucks an ounce. I apologize if I am way off on this. I haven't been collecting gold and silver for a while, so I'm a little weak on my numbers, but I can tell you silver is way undervalued. Thank you, central banks. Gold is way undervalued. Once again, thank you, central banks. But I think gold is about $1,500 an ounce. If you see one of those laying around, definitely pick it up. If you run into those half dollars, again, anything before, what is it, 1960, grab those. And there are a plethora of websites out there. I am looking down one right now. I'm not even going to be able to pronounce this. The Numismatic. Did I say that? I said that wrong. There's websites, guys. Just look for professional coin grading websites. You have your coins and you look them up. And I'm sure after a while, it's kind of like for me, I knew when I went to a garage sale and I saw, I got another story for you, Nintendo 64. Remember that? Does that bring back some memories? Oh, this husband's gonna, I don't think this marriage was going to last after I left the house. Let me explain. In the front yard, there was all these N64. Got my handy dandy scanner, and I scanned one. And this is inbox, and it's like $345. I'm like, wow, okay, I guess, you know, N64 stuff. And I'm scanning all of these, and they had ridiculous values. I couldn't believe it. And I go, how much for all of it? She's like, oh, I don't know, my husband would kill me. She's like, I don't know, $20. I'm like, here is $20 plus a $200 tip. Thank you very much. So when it comes to like how to look these things up, use the internet. There's a plethora of websites so you can check each coin. But Bill, I don't have that much coinage in my house. We only trade cryptocurrency, so it doesn't, that's why you're gonna go to the banks. You go into a bank and you actually get rolls of coins, like $100 or start with $20 worth of pennies. Now, what you don't wanna do is, you don't wanna be not a nice person because the banks don't have to do this. So you go into the bank and say, hey, can I have $100 of pennies or $100 of whatever? You go home, you check it all, you take out the good stuff. Typically, they say it's between 1-2% of your stuff is good. So then you take the good stuff, you set it aside, take your bad stuff, and you take it back into the bank. Just do not take it back into the bank that you got it from, because you're gonna look really annoying. So you're gonna wanna have a few banks. Like for me, my wallet's not around, but I have a lot of banks. Not saying like, ooh, you got a lot of a banks. A lot of a banks, it's Italian. Because I have different bank accounts. I'm weird, I can't even believe I'm saying this on camera. I like separating certain things, like just different. Like my Amazon accounts are one way and my eBay is another way and I got my personal one way. I have accounts all over the place. Plus, I do those credit cards where they're like, we'll give you, because I have pretty good credit. And for business accounts, if I start one up, I did a video on it, maybe I'll put it above my head. This is pretty cool. Easy way to get maybe around $800. I opened up a business account. I think it was Citibank, and they gave me, I think it was $500 or $750 just for opening it. And then you spend some and then that's it. And they give you the money. And I did a video on it and people were like, boo. Like, I don't know. Easy way for me to make $750. But you need to be friends and nice. Be a nice guy with these tellers when you bring it in. Just like, here it is. And you go to a different bank. So you get coins from one bank. And then after you go through it, you return it to a different bank. Because they're going to go, man, you're making us do a lot of work here, Bill. And again, guys, this is a side hustle. A lot of the stuff that I do on this channel is side hustles. Easy way, you know, I have high school students. They're like, I'm 15 or I'm 14, what can I do? Well, you can do this. This is a way for you to start making 15 grand a year just by going to banks. But I don't drive. Well, then walk. And you have to be patient. Patience, my friend. There's a virtue about that, right? But be patient, enjoy it. If you don't enjoy it, then don't do it. It's kind of like online arbitrage. Link in the description on that was my very first course that I did that I have my high school kids do. Have another one doing it right now. And they were making a couple $1,000s a month. They're like 14. And all you have to do is you buy something from a coupon site and then you sell it on Amazon. It's not rocket sauce nor science. It's very simple. Again, it kind of comes with I have the two courses. I have one, which is online arbitrage, which it's that, where you're buying it from coupon sites and then you're reselling it on Amazon. And then I have private label. So you actually get both of them, but this is a side hustle. Here, you go to banks, you check out the pennies, nickels, dimes, quarters. And if that's working great and you're doing your online arbitrage, that's great. That's generating income. And then you take all that money and you do private label, you create your own brand, you make, you know, can't say any numbers, but it's definitely life-changing. I would do it if I was your age. I don't care how old are you, unless you're above the age of, you know, 110, then you should probably throw in the towel. Videos every single week. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.